Oh, hello again, people. You're tuned in to BoomBox Deluxe's channel once again, and in today's video, I'm going to be having a little talk to you about that metering board, okay? Now, we've all seen what it can do. I've done a few meters here and there. I've made them go forwards and backwards and all over the place. We've done a few accuracy tests and whatnot. You're looking at the base of the board there at the moment, which doesn't appear to have anything on it. Okay, it does obviously have the control panel at the top there, the double socket, which is outlet, the inlet there, and meter number one, as we very well know. But what I'm looking at doing, people, in this video is, well, let's just say this is a quick sort of news update video, okay, because I want to give this an upgrade, because as we very well know, excuse me, I had an itchy ear hole, okay, so let's go again. What I plan to do on this board is I'm getting itchy fingers, and I want to give this metering board an update, shall we say, an upgrade. I want to get some more features and functions and little toys and hocus pocus going on there. And here's how I'm going to do it. On our control panel up top there, hold on a moment, what's that? It's kitten number two. What are you doing up there, number two? Come on, down from up there you come. You shouldn't be playing with wires. I'll tell Toby off for doing that. You should not be playing with wires. Come here. You can sit down there. Right. Before I was so rudely interrupted, people, what I want to do with this metering board is, on here, I have got two blanks. They're not doing anything. Okay. I want to whip those out, and I want to put extra functionality in there. Okay. Now, we've got a big empty space down the bottom there. Okay, now, I did say in another video that I do plan a little bit later on, i.e. now, to make use of that empty space and put some extra toys and bits and pieces on it. And that is where this comes in. Yes, it's a Horstmann Rate-changer. Number three, get off the time switch, please. Come on. Come sit with number two. The kittens are getting everywhere today, people. Right, Horstmann rate changer time switch. Okay. It's a VMK7 SRS, that. And I want to put that time switch in that empty space, just underneath that socket. Okay. So that's the new toy that's going to go on there. Because, I mean, this meter testing board, it does test dual tariff electricity meters. And I kind of figured that, seeing as it's got the options on there for the normal and low, okay, that's those there, that one and that one, those two switches, it would be nice if I had an option on there to have a rate changer, and I'll be able to test the rate changing option on the time switch, and as such, when the time switch turns on, I'm going to reconfigure the wiring inside that control panel so that when the time switch turns on, that one there, it changes the meter over to the low rate, okay? And I will also, as always, have the manual options. I'll leave the manual options on there, okay? So I'm going to put the Horstmann rate changer on there, down the bottom there. Now, another thing that the Horstmann rate changer can do is obviously switch a load. While that time switch is on that board, it would be rude, really, not to take advantage of its load switching capabilities. Okay, it is a rate changer, but it could also switch a load at the same time. Given that, I kind of figured I would be able to make use of that option, and pop. Yes, I'm going to put another socket on the board. Okay, and I'm going to put that socket just down there Okay, I cannot have it too close to that because I've got to get got to take into account the space for a coupler to go in there. So I'm going to put that socket down there in the corner. Okay, just about there, like that. There'll be enough space underneath it to let the flex out of the plug. And that socket is going to go down there. And as we can see, that leaves plenty of space there for a coupler to go into the appliance inlets. So that socket's going to go down the bottom there. And that socket will be operated by the time switch. Okay. So, what I can do with that, bearing in mind I do shoot a few videos here and there, is when I recharge my camera batteries, I can set the time switch for a certain amount of hours, plug the battery charger in there, put the batteries in, switch it on, and then after a certain amount of hours the time switch turns off, and I don't then have to worry about going back and checking whether the batteries are charged, because I know that they've been fully charged and then the time switch has turned the power off. Okay. And of course, I will wire it up with the proper sized cable, of course, so I can put anything else in there and have it time switch operated, because the time switch will take the load, as will the rest of the metering board and all the wiring contained on it. Okay, because that metering board, it will run quite happily at 16 amps all day long. But bearing in mind, I'll normally connect that into a 13 amp wall socket, so I'm going to have to limit that down to 13 amps. Okay, so it's all there, it's all looking good so far, but there's more people. I want to get more functionality onto that metering board, and that means taking that double socket and removing it. Okay, now in its place I am going to put another four-way little control panel. Okay, it's about the same size as that. Okay, and it's going to go there, and then that socket, I'm going to move it down to here. Okay, and then underneath that socket there will be enough space there for the time switch, the rate changer. I'm going to put that there, like that. Okay, now it doesn't look much space there in order to get another double socket in, but what I plan to do is, you see that black enamel coupler there? There it is. Okay, the black enamel coupler. I plan to remove that. And when I put in the extra functionality little control panel, which is the same dimensions as that wall socket, what I plan to do is I plan to close couple that right up to that other control panel. And then when I put the socket back on, I should close couple the socket to the extra little control panel, so we'll have that big control panel, and then another little new one down there, and then a socket, the double socket can go there, the rate changer time switch can go there, the little single socket, which is going to be time switch controlled, can go in the corner there, and yes, that will be it. Okay, now I suppose you want to see all the little bits and toys that are going to go onto the new little control panel. Well, it's here, people. I've got all the parts. And it's coming up in front of the camera now. There we go. Okay. As we can see, there's cable sealing glands in there, or stuffing glands as they're sometimes called. We've got in there some brass bushes with little lock rings on. That is so that I can close couple the boxes to each other. Okay, the brass bush will go in one box, and it will pass through into the other box, and then I should put the lock ring on, and that will then close couple the boxes together, through the centre of which all the wiring goes. Okay, those two cable sealing glands are obviously going to come out of the control panel, a bit like those two on the top there. Okay, and yeah, it's going to be flexes coming out of there going to the terminals on the bottom of our time switch there. Okay, I'm going to fully wire that as well. And I'm going to wire that in such a way that I can give it some fun jiggery pokery. Okay, not so much the fun aspect of it, but more in a case of jiggery pokery, because as we very well know, those time switches, what they do is they just, you set it, okay, and it turns on and off, on and off, on and off every 24 hours, and it just keeps doing it and doing it, okay, because that's what it's designed to do. Okay, it's a 24-hour rate-changing time switch. But this is BoomBox Deluxe's kitchen, people, and I want to give it some extra functionality and some little new fun function options, okay? And that's what that little control panel's for there, up in front of the camera. Now, it doesn't look much of a control panel at the moment because it's just in pieces. Let's take those elastic bands off there and let's examine all the parts. There's one elastic band, two kittens. Okay, I'm so glad they're behaving themselves, but one should not have been up on top of the control panel, and the other one should not have been on top of that time switch. Okay, they do occasionally misbehave. Right, so there's our bag of accessories just sitting loosely on the top there. And we all look at this. We've got a red indicator in there. I'm going to explain what that does in a minute. But there's our control panel, a new little extra control panel. As you can see, there's four holes in that. Okay, one, two, three, four. And there's a little blue bag in there. Because, as you remember me saying with that one, when I got that faceplate, it was on a job lot auction. And as you can see, it's got a screw missing there and there. I've had to rummage through my pile of screws, and I came up with only two that fitted in there, okay, because the threaded holes inside there, they are not your 3.5mm sized, okay, those are 3.5mm sized, okay, and again, with that single socket, I bought that on discount, but can you see something missing, people? Yes, it hasn't got the fixing screws, okay, there's the box. Normally speaking, when you buy one of these and it's in the packet, you look around on the back there and the two screws are fixed in there, one down there, and you just dig them out with a screwdriver. But can you see any screws on the back there? Nope. It's obviously been removed out of the packet. The screws have dropped out, and the person thought to myself, well, it's no use, so he sold it on a discount. And I do know that I can get replacement screws to go in there. They're only standard 3.5mm ones. And yeah, so I got that on a discount. Okay, so there we go. Complete box. So there we go. So yes, although I can get replacement 3.5mm screws for those go in there. They are not your standard 3.5mm screws. So what I was saying is, when you get a faceplate, if you buy it off of someone and it's not in the packet, make sure you get the little blue bag. Okay, there's a little blue bag in there. So you get the outer packet here. And then inside there, there's another little packet. There it is. You see it sliding up and down? That's a little packet with a special screws in it. Okay. I obviously bought this one brand new on full price. Okay, they don't cost too much. Part number for that is K3494ALM, and it's a 4-gang surface metal front plate. Okay, that's what that is. And that's obviously going to go on the front of our box there, and we've got some toys in there, people. Let's dig them out and take a look. There's already one in there. I'm going to explain what that indicator does in a minute. And we've got some switches. Now, I'm not going to go into part numbers and all that. We're just going to dig the parts out and have a look at them. One switch. Two. Three. Four. And five. Okay, there's five switches there. Now, you're probably thinking, there's five switches, but there's only four holes. How am I going to do that? Well, if you count those four holes there, and those two blanks there, that makes six. And I've got five, plus that red indicator. Okay? Now, what that red indicator is for is, if you remember our time switch there, that one, what I'm going to do, remember that socket, when that time switch turns on, I'm going to have that little indicator light up to say that firstly the time switch is on, and secondly to indicate that socket's powered up. Okay, so that's what that little indicator is for. I got that on a discount. Okay, some sockist was having a bit of a clear out, and I got that on half price discount. Okay, and there was a few others, and I grabbed those as well, and I chucked those in my spares box. Okay, they're always nice to have, but I really do believe that they are overpriced for what they are. I got that one on a discount. Okay, so yes. Right, that's it. Okay, there's all our switches. They're different types of switch because I'll need each switch to do a different function. Okay, once again, people, I'm sorry to say that I cannot explain the wiring that's going to go into there and what's inside that control panel because they are a proprietary wiring configuration, which is obviously my property. And yes, it's all a bit, well, copyrighted, of course, you know. But yes, so I've got some switches here where they're like duplicates. Okay, let's have a look at them on the backs of them. Right, those two are the same. Okay, what's this one? That is, that's a 4892 WHI, 20 amp SP two way. So obviously speaking, being 20 amp and two way, you know what I'm like for using those as changeover switches. So that's obviously going to be a changeover for some little function. Ah, we got one of those intermediate switches again. Okay, now I've not yet explained what the extra functionality is that I'm going to do on that time switch. And that is where the intermediate switch comes in. And what's this one? It's a 20 amp SP two way again, which means more changeover options. Okay. Because I've got on this a few options where I want either one option or the other. And to do that, I do need, firstly, a switch that can take the full load, so hence 20 amps. And it being a two-way, so I can wire it as a changeover. Okay. So, those two switches are the same. 20 amp two-way, but I'm going to use those as changeovers. Yeah, and those are 10 amp SP two ways, so again more changeover options, and a 20 amp intermediate. Now what that one's going to be used for is I've designed a little circuit, shall we say, and what I plan to do with that time switch is I'm going to get a dual functionality out of that, and here's what's going to happen. Now I've already explained with that time switch that you set it to a certain time, it turns on and off, on and off, on and off 24 hours every time. With that switch, right, I'll be able to press it in the other option, right, and what that will then do, enable me to set that time switch to a certain time. Okay, it'll operate. And then, when it switches off, not only does it turn that socket off, but it will also switch itself off as well. Okay? So that'll be a nice little extra bonus function. So you're going to have to come back a little bit later on to see all this, people, wired up. Thanks for watching.